Hi everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving deep into the subatomic world to explore the fundamental building blocks of matter, quarks. But before we get there, let's set the stage with a quick rundown of the standard model. Imagine a family tree, but instead of people, it shows all the fundamental particles we know of. That's kind of what the standard model is. It groups these particles into three main families. Quarks. We'll get to these superstars in a minute. Leptons. These include electrons, the tiny negatively charged particles that zip around the nucleus of an atom. And bosons. These are the messengers, carrying the forces that make particles interact with each other, like the photon for light. The standard model is fantastic at explaining pretty much everything we see in the everyday world, from the way atoms behave to how light interacts with matter. But here's the thing, science is constantly evolving. Experiments done as recently as 2023 and 2024 are hinting at anomalies that the standard model can't fully explain. This suggests there might be more particles and forces out there waiting to be discovered. But this is a topic for another video. All right, enough with the intro, let's talk quarks. Quarks are the true building blocks of protons and neutrons, which are the heavyweights of the atomic nucleus. There are six types of quarks, each with its own quirky personality. Up and down, these are the most common and lightest of the bunch. Think of them as the basic building blocks. Charm and strange. A bit heavier than up and down quarks, these guys add some variety to the mix. Top and bottom, the heavyweight champions of the quark world. They're super unstable and exist for only a tiny fraction of a second. One interesting thing about quarks is their fractional electric charge. Unlike electrons with their whole number charge, minus one, quarks can have charges of positive two-thirds or negative one-third. Protons are made up of two up quarks, each with a charge of positive two-thirds, and one down quark with a charge of negative one-third. Adding these charges together gives us two-thirds plus two-thirds minus one-third equal positive one, which is the overall charge of a proton. Neutrons, on the other hand, consist of two down quarks and one up quark. Two down quark charges add up to negative one-third plus negative one-third equal negative two-thirds. When we add this to the charge of the up quark, positive two-thirds, they cancel out and we get zero, which is the net charge of a neutron. So how do these little quarks come together to form protons and neutrons? It all boils down to the strong nuclear force, the glue that holds quarks together. This force is incredibly strong, much stronger than the electrical force, which attracts protons and electrons, or the gravity that keeps us grounded. It's the reason protons and neutrons can exist within the nucleus, despite the repulsive force between their positive charges. Now, here's where things get a little strange, or quirky, if you will. Quarks have a property called color charge, but it's not related to the colors we see in the real world. Instead, think of it as a kind of charge that comes in three varieties: red, green, and blue. Unlike electric charge, positive or negative, these color charges can be in any of those three possible states. Here's the key twist. Quarks can never be in a state where their color charges don't cancel each other out. This is why quarks are always confined within protons and neutrons, where their color charges can be balanced. It's like the strong nuclear force is constantly looking for color balance. Think of it this way. Imagine red, green, and blue building blocks. To make a stable structure, you either need all three colors together, like a white proton, or a combination where the colors cancel out, like a neutral neutron. The strong nuclear force acts like an invisible force field, pulling these color-charged quarks together into these stable combinations, forming the building blocks of atoms. Quarks are full of surprises. Here are some mind-bending facts. We can never directly observe a single quark on its own. Because of the strong nuclear force, quarks are always confined within protons, neutrons, or other particles called mesons. This strong attraction between quarks gets even stronger if you try to separate them. The more you pull, the stronger the force becomes. This phenomenon is called confinement, And it's one of the reasons why our understanding of quarks comes from studying how they behave within other particles, rather than observing them directly. Even though they make up most of the mass of protons and neutrons, quarks themselves contribute very little to the overall mass of an atom. The majority of an atom's mass comes from the energy of the gluons, the particles that carry the strong nuclear force and bind the quarks together. Think of it like this. The mass of the quarks is like a tiny pebble, but the energy of the gluons is like a giant beach ball, making the whole proton or neutron much heavier. Quarks are a fascinating window into the fundamental nature of our universe. And as we continue to explore the subatomic world with more powerful particle accelerators, we may discover even more about these tiny building blocks and their role in the grand scheme of things. Thanks for joining us on this exploration of quarks. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more scientific adventures. And if you have any questions about quarks or anything else science-related, leave a comment below and we'll be happy to discuss.